Hi guys, so today's video is going to be a list of 6 different fantasy standalones. 3 of them are going to be adult fantasy, and then 3 of them are going to be young adult. And if you're still looking for more fantasy recommendations, I will have my 2 other standalone videos in the description bar down below. But jumping into this one and starting with one that is probably a little bit lesser known, we have Hall of Smoke by H.M. Long. This is a standalone, but I do want to add that the author has said they are going to be writing a companion story that chronologically takes place after this one, but it's not necessarily a direct sequel. So I just want to get that out of the way. And then also, if you end up liking this one, you have that to look forward to. This story follows a battle-hardened warrior priestess who serves the goddess of war. And at the very beginning of the story, we see this particular character named Hessa, who is trying to ask for forgiveness for directly disobeying an order that she was given by the goddess. You don't really know if it was a direct order, if they really truly can communicate with these higher powers. You don't know if the main character did this on accident, if they disobeyed purposefully. You don't really know exactly what's going on. But while this character is trying to beg for forgiveness, some terrible events take place that result in this character losing a lot of what their life was made up of. And so the rest of the story, they're trying to both grieve for everything they have lost while simultaneously getting caught within a lot of maneuverings between what are possibly gods and goddesses. It's a very interesting story. It's very atmospheric. It is somewhat dry in the sense that the character is grieving. So I would say it's not exactly a lighthearted story. There really aren't very funny moments throughout, but if you're looking for something that feels rather cold, something that feels very Norse and somewhat Viking inspired, if you're just looking for that very atmospheric feel, I definitely think that that fits the bill. Switching gears and going into a YA fantasy, and one that a lot of people have picked up, that would be An Enchantment of Ravens. This is a love story. This is very cute, very cozy, very familiar. All of the things that you kind of come to expect from a cozy YA fantasy, you're probably going to get with this. So if you're somebody who's not looking for a book that reinvents the wheel, if you're not necessarily looking for something extremely different and unique and captivating, this story, what it is at its core, is this love story. It's a little bit of a traveling story. It's very fairy tale-like. The story is that we have this main character who, she is a human girl who gets whisked off to the Fae land after depicting this particular Fae person as having very raw emotions, very human emotions. She was hired to paint him, and in painting him this way, he is now seen as weak among the other Fae. So a lot of the aspects of the wickedness of Fae and the idea that the Fae can't necessarily create things themselves, a lot of this folklore aspect to Fae is definitely present in this story. And it's just very whimsical. It's also very, very short, so it's a good one to pick up between maybe some of the bigger fantasy books or bigger fantasy series. And the writing style is just lovely, very atmospheric. Also, I think a very good one to pick up in the fall. Another book that's great for fall would be Uprooted. I do want to clarify that I didn't actually particularly care for this story, but I don't mind recommending books even if they didn't work for me, because hopefully they will work for you. This story follows a woman named Agnieszka who is living in this small village where they are really close to this very horrifying forest. It does terrible things to people. It's very scary. And there is this being that lives in this tower. He's basically a wizard, and they have to give one of the women of the village over to him in exchange for his protection from this creepy forest. And you don't really know what happens to the women when they are given over to this person, but eventually they come out of everything and they're like, yeah, everything was fine, I'm good. And they don't seem harmed, they don't seem like it was a terrible time, so the villagers don't really feel too bad about giving a girl over. And our main character is the woman who is given to this particular man, and you're kind of following the story with the two of them. It is very atmospheric, very folklore inspired, where An Enchantment of Ravens is very cute, and there's definitely the wickedness of the Fae, but it's ultimately a lovely story. This one, I would never describe as lovely. It's quite dark and honestly almost horror-like in the way that the forest is described and the things that the forest is capable of. I actually loved that aspect of the book. The reason that I didn't personally love it is because I found our main character to not be my favorite character to follow. But if you like folklore inspired stories, if you like stories that are a little bit scary, a little bit creepy, and if you like this old fairy tale like feel, then this one is going to be perfect for you. I did not intend for this whole video to be filled with books that are great for the colder seasons, but this next one I just think is also a good book to read for winter, and that would be Warrior of the Wild by Trisha Levenseller. When I first picked this book up, I thought it was going to be far more serious, and I was so surprised at how precious this story is. So if you need a pick-me-up, if you need something that just makes you feel delightful, I would highly recommend this. It follows a girl who is living in this very loosely Viking-inspired village, and she is shunned from her village, and she now has to try and live in the wild. And in order to come back to her village, she has to fulfill this task that was assigned to her. But these tasks are purposefully impossible, basically. And so she is likely never going to be able to come home. She's likely going to have to live in this forest forever. And while living in the forest, she finds two other young men who are also shunned from their village. And the three of them band together to help each other with the tasks that they've been assigned. But just seeing the way that these three come together, become friends, butt heads, bicker, they don't necessarily want to rely on each other sometimes, but then other times it's like power of friendship kind of a story. And it was just, it was, again, to use the same word, it was delightful. It was so delightful. I absolutely was taken away by it. I didn't think it was going to be anything exceptional. And again, it's not reinventing the wheel, like I was saying about Enchantment of Ravens. It's not the most unique of stories, but I just have found that this author, I've read three of their works now, and I just always have a good time with them. They're fun, they're great pick-me-ups, and also short. Once again, short, not just a standalone, but one that doesn't have too many pages to it. This video might as well have just been called Fall and Winter Recommendations, because this next one I have recommended also for the fall season in the past, and that would be Elantris by Brandon Sanderson. So the setup for this story is there is this man named Raedon, and he's the prince of this particular land that is very close to this old city called Elantris. And Elantris used to be this gleaming, beautiful city. The people that lived within this city, they had something called the Shaead that turned them into these godlike beings. And then one day, the Shaead went from turning people into godlike beings to turning them into kind of zombies. It's actually awful imagining this particular thing, because when they are injured, the pain never really goes away. So something as simple as stubbing your toe, that pain will always be with you, and you basically, you never die, but you also never heal. You're stuck in this awful in between. And our main character is somebody who's just very enthusiastic, somebody who's always optimistic, and he gets the Shaead, and he gets thrown into Elantris secretly. They don't want people to know that that's where he went, so they tell his betrothed that he died, and his betrothed is now navigating the politics of this place that she was supposed to be married into. And on top of that, there is this priest that is trying to convince everybody of the evils of Elantris, and he is one of the most fascinating aspects of this book. Last on the list, we have Woven in Moonlight by Isabel Ibanez. So this particular story is actually a little bit controversial, because the author is somebody who has grown up in America, and her family grew up in South America, and so she's sort of pulling from her family's history, but growing up in America means that some of the representation in this book is not necessarily something that people who actually live in South America feel is extremely accurate. And then on top of that, some of the themes in this story are not the easiest to read, because you're following a main character who is basically a part of a group of people who colonized another group of people. So our main character, she at the beginning of the book is living in exile with her people. She is this stand-in figure for the actual royal, so that if there's ever an attack, if there's ever an assassination attempt, they'll go after our main character thinking that she is the royal figure not realizing that she's actually just a decoy, and there's an opportunity for this character to actually get into the city and potentially marry the leader that has kind of pushed her people out of exile. So there's a chance for peace if they're willing to bow down to the people that exiled them in the first place, and they see these people as the enemy. They see them as bad. They see them as they pushed us out of our land, except for that their ancestors actually are the ones that took the land from them. And so it's difficult to read because our main character is naive to this initially. And so she believes with her whole heart that this is her city, that this city belongs to her people, and that these enemies are actually at fault for everything. And she's very naive for a very long time. And it's not the easiest thing for a lot of people to pick up. I do think that part of the growth in the story is our main character starting to see that the history of the peoples, both hers and the enemy, is not as simple as it seems. But again, just because there are some real world tie-ins to this, especially when it comes to the religious aspects and how they view the people that were native to the land, it's one of the reasons why it's very controversial. Go into it knowing that there are going to be some, you're seeing this through the lens of almost an unreliable narrator. That's it for some adult and young adult standalone fantasy books. Like I said at the beginning, will have my other fantasy standalone videos linked in the description bar down below. Let me know what some of your favorite standalones are. As I keep reading more standalones, I will happily continue to make more of these videos. And if I have any individual book reviews for the books mentioned, I'll have them linked also. But anyway, thanks so much for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you all later. Bye.